What's up, everybody? This is Concrete Zebra with Craftmaster Productions and Studio1Tutorials.com, and today we're going to be going over some old school Manny Fresh drum theory. Ladies and gentlemen, little boys and girls, cats and dogs, babies, mamas and daddies, and everybody in between. Today, we are going to be going over the magnificent, the incredible Manny Fresh, the granddaddy of trap music and one of my favorite producers. This is a request that I see upon just all different tutorial YouTube pages, because I see all of them. You know, I make my own, and I haven't really seen anybody dig into it, so I'm gonna give it to y'all. I'm gonna give it to Busy Works Beats. We're just gonna go over something like this real quick. That's right. That right there, that drum pattern, that's that signature old school Manny Fresh drum pattern. There's some things that you got to know if you want to do. I know that I've talked to a lot of different people, especially rappers. You know, they'll be like, yo, I wish that I could just get like Manny Fresh drums and then something. Like, a lot of people have this same idea that I've come across down in Miami. Like, yo, I want to take old school Manny Fresh drums and do something with them. So this could definitely be like a cool sonic bed for you to kind of create another type of, you know, your own different type of subgenre. If you notice, like, a lot of the, you know, the 130 and the 140 and the 120, like, that stuff is still going, but especially like in a lot of the newer, more popular songs, like, you're starting to see you know, kind of like a shift back into straight time, getting up around 82, 83, 45, 86 sometimes. So that right there is really Manny Fresh land as far as tempo is concerned. So, you know, if you're interested in trying to set something off like that, the first thing that you start with, obviously, is your drums. You're gonna want to find you an 808. The 808s that Manny used to use, it was like an actual 808, like off the machine. So you got to kind of replicate that. The one that I picked, this came out of a Superstar OPAC. This is out of the Trap Legends kit. This is one. It's called the Boomin 808, and it's the plainest 808 in there. It's the less saturated. That's why I picked it. It sounds like this. Now, the thing about it is the 808s that producers used back then, coming off that 808 machine, they weren't these super long-tailed 808s. So whatever DAW that you're using, you need to go up in your sampler, however you're triggering it, and you need to shorten your release so that it's about this long. I'm sorry. You know, just like a short, a medium hit, you know, nothing that's going to carry over from kick to kick. You want to give it room to breathe. Then you want to go ahead and grab yourself whatever kick that you've been using up to this point. Okay, you don't have to use the one that I use. You can use whatever kick you've been using up to this point to stack 808s with. Typically, it's a kick that just has a really short release. I like the Mafia kick out of the Superstar O Trap Legends pack. It's just a plain kick, doesn't have a lot of, you know, no acoustic tones over it. For a snare, you just want a regular short snare, an 808 type of snare, even like an acoustic snare that has a lot of lows rolled off. Just, you know, something that's going to punch through. You're going to want to get you a regular, just a basic trap hi-hat. You know, something really short, because these notes are going to be all coming at you. And then you want to get something in the background, like either like a, just some type of impact sample, like either something like this sound here, like that'll work, or record scratch, just something that you can put on the and beats so that you can add variation to it. The first thing that you can go with is the snare. The snare is really easy on these tracks. It's nothing too crazy. Since we're in straight time, we're gonna be dealing with you're gonna be at 88 beats per minute. You're gonna be dropping your snares on the twos and the fours, on the two and the four beats. Now what you want to do is you want to set your grid to 16ths, and you want to add this little syncopated hit right here. Syncopated means it comes right before a beat. Like when you're in the 16th note resolution, you drop a hit right before, you know, this would be your 1, 2, 3, 4 beat. So if you add a syncopated hit right there, and you're going to do that on the second snare of each bar. And then once you get to your fourth bar, you get that signature Manny Fresh snare roll that happens obnoxiously at the end of like every fourth bar. And the way that you draw that in is you want to set your grid to 32 notes, and you're going to have your first snare on your four beat. Then the easiest way to do it is the way that I like to do it is I'll set my grid to 16th notes, and then you just cut in another one right next to that snare. Then you could drop it down to 32 and just slice it, and then that's how you get this sound. And that's what you want, that little ta 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 ta. So again, you know, if you're on FL Studio, just, you know, I know they name their grid completely different than every other DAW. So instead of 132, I think it's like, you know, 6 steps or 8 steps or something like that. But you can just zoom in and, you know, just adjust your grid to where you get it like that, and you'll be able to get this same sound. So your snare pattern is going to sound like this. All right, now the kick pattern is super easy. You're just going boom, 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 boom. That's it. Doom, 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 doom. And again, these are just 16 note hits. All right, so once you get that down, you're gonna go into your hi-hat, and if you're in a fruity step sequencer, you could just go to I think it's like fill 16 will get you the sound. But you're gonna have to jump into the piano roll anyway to make these rolls. The way that you get these rolls is after the 2 beat and the 4 beat, you're just gonna take that hi-hat right there and slice it into 32 notes. And that's in straight time. 16ths are going to give you that fast, rapid hi-hat sound. And then you just want to go into 32 notes and make, and you know, every so often just make little, you know, be creative with it. Don't just copy this drum pattern verbatim. You know, just go and kind of add, you know, a 32 note roll here, a 32 note roll over here. You know, just go and have fun with it. This is what mine sounded like. And instantly right there, like just based off of that snare roll, these hi-hats and that kick pattern, like you're already getting the Manny vibe. So when you go ahead and you add a stomp on, when you add a stomp on your downbeat, and then you go on the ands after your four. So you know you've got 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. All right, So you drop it, you drop that on your and after every four beat, bam, 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 and you wind up with this. You know, and you could use whatever you want there. I mean, you could put a vocal sample or something, you know, that Lex Luger vocal sample if you want, whatever, something brand new. But it's just to add to the rhythm. So once you got that, I mean, you got that, boom, like you have the Manny Fresh sound right there, 88 beats per minute. Then all you want to do is go ahead and add your bass. And for the bass, all you want to do is you take your kick pattern, copy the exact same kick pattern, and drop it on your 808. Remember, you want to shorten the release of your 808. You don't want it playing the whole tail. Then it's just going to sound like fast trap. It's not going to sound like, you know, like old school Manny Fresh. So if you go ahead and you just make a short release so that this kick doesn't overlap with this kick, you're going to get this sound. You hear how that tail runs out, like right here? That's what you want. You want to give the track room to breathe, especially when it's moving this quick. Now, the thing that made Manny so dope was he wasn't just like, especially back in that time, like a lot of East Coast producers were, where their drums would just loop the whole beat and, you know, they do some dropouts. He would always have like variations in the pattern. So when that eighth bar came around, this was a really famous break he would do. He would go ahead and take his kick and for half a bar, chop it into 32 notes. So you get this really nice stutter. But for the 808, he would pitch it. So he would take like an eighth note at one note, an eighth note at another note, an eighth note, and just keep dropping it down, right? So you wind up with this. And that once you go from these two repeated patterns to adding this, now you're really getting like that. That's the authentic Manny Fresh vibe. That's how you're gonna get it really into that territory, is by adding this level of detail to the variation of your drums. And just think about it. This is just your drums. You know, this is what made this dude great, because when you go back and you listen to them old Hot Boy beats and you realize how much the beat is changing throughout the course of the song, it's almost like every rapper, especially on the Hot Boy records, has their own variation of the beat. You know, that's how you get to see like why this dude is who he is. Then for your last variation, a real easy trick is to take that snare pattern that you had, the fourth and the eighth bar, this one right here, you copy and paste it to your kick pattern. And what it's going to do, it's that whole thing where your mind is expecting a certain amount of repetition when it's listening to music, but you give it that repetition because it needs it. Otherwise, your mind is instantly going to think the song is weird and it's going to turn it off. But what you do is you change that rhythm from a snare to a kick, and now all of a sudden you've given the mind a new puzzle piece that still fits into the bigger picture, thus creating interest. And the reaction is in the... because this is all happening in the listener's subconscious mind, the reaction to the listener is like, wow, this is a really amazing beat. So just based off of that, you hear that, you hear how those parts come together. You know, you go ahead and you build that first pattern. You know, you make sure you have those syncopated dodgy snares in it. You keep that short and simple snare roll. You know, you don't want to go into your trap programming mentality where you want to put this crazy, you know, super pitched snare stud or anything like that. You keep the hi-hats pretty simple, but it's just the way that you add the interest is by, over the course of the 16 bar verse, you make sure that you don't repeat. You want to go ahead and add small variations to the end of each one of these four bar sections, and that's what's really going to raise the level of the art of these drums. And then once you have these drums, you know, you can go ahead and just you know, put whatever you want on top of it, and then really start creating your own Manny Fresh inspired music. Anyways, I hope this tip helped you guys out. You know, remember, you can put whatever you want on top of this. You can chop up samples, you know, any VST, you know, different types of bass lines, however you want to freak it. This is Concrete Zebra with Craftmaster Productions, Studio1Tutorials.com. Keep it simple. Don't be basic. And we'll see y'all on the next one.